Hi, I'm Lara, and this is Trip Train Trilogy, and today on Trip Talk, I'll be discussing character arcs. The reason I wanted to discuss character arcs is because it's a new year, people are making New Year's resolutions, so it seemed appropriate. Character arcs are a very complicated topic, so I did a lot of research before this, and one blog post I found very helpful was KM Whelan's blog post on helping writers become authors, how to write a character arc, and I will link that below. What I have to say isn't exactly what she said, however, what I do say is based on her main points and somewhat tweaked for my less structured method. And also, I give a lot more story examples. Also, I would like to note this is just my opinion. I'm not an expert, but I thought it would be nice to have a little discussion on character arcs. And now, let's get right into the video. A character arc is when a character transforms in an internal and meaningful way throughout the course of the story. And the reason I specify internal is because though a lot of stories feature training sequences where the character gets better at physically fighting, that is not the same. And though physical changes with the character can either reflect internal changes or trigger internal changes, they are not the same thing. Now, not every story needs a character arc. For example, James Bond and Indiana Jones are both successful stories without character arcs. Hence why the first movie in this series is called Indiana Jones and the Lost Ark. And the reason why these stories work without character arcs is because they're kind of like adventures of the week for these characters, and the main focus of the story is the external conflict, not the character's internal conflict. However, despite the fact that some stories don't need character arcs, I definitely recommend you try to include one, because a good character arc can only improve your story. I specify good because if your character arc is completely crap, then it might make your story worse. If you choose to include a character arc, it's important to know that the main basis for this character arc is the lie your character believes. The lie the character believes should be what they think they need versus what they actually need. And an example of a character's goal or what they think they need not being what they actually need would be if your character thinks they need romantic love, but in actuality they need to fix their broken family relationships. Or if your character thinks they need revenge, but actually they need to learn to forgive. In KM Whelan's blog, she analyzes character arc plot point by plot point. And to be completely honest, that's a bit too specific for me. I personally think to make your character arc really pack a punch, you need three specific scenes. Now, between these scenes, your character should be constantly improving and unimproving. However, these scenes should be the most extreme to really make your character's lie and truth hit home. And though a lot of times character arcs are portrayed as going from one point to the next with maybe one dip, but everything else is improvement, I personally think it's more realistic if your character constantly improves and unimproves throughout the story. Back to the three scenes I think are important to making your character's arc really pack a punch are the characteristic moment, the breaking point, and the climactic moment where the character either embraces the truth or succumbs to the lie. So the first scene is the characteristic moment, which is when we should be first introduced to your character. This characteristic moment should accurately represent your character and demonstrate their characteristic flaw. A good example of a characteristic moment is Tally Youngblood's introduction in Uglies. This scene features Tally Youngblood sneaking into Pretty Town to see her childhood friend. While reading this scene, you might be focused on Tally's sense of friendship or her super sneaking ninja skills. However, the lie that Tally believes is the main motivation for this scene, and that lie is that Tally believes that she is incomplete as an ugly and needs to become a pretty in order to become complete and happy, which is part of the reason why Tally is so obsessed with Pretty Town. And I think this is such a great example of a characteristic moment because her lie is the main motivation for her actions in this scene. The second scene needed is the breaking point, which should be later in the second act. Now, before this scene happens, the lie should hurt the character. However, this is the scene where the lie hurts them the most. A good example of this is Disney's Aladdin. The breaking point in this movie is when Jafar reveals that Aladdin isn't a prince. In this moment, Aladdin is forced to confront the fact that he has been living a lie. And the third scene is when the character finally acts on the lie and they either embrace the truth or succumb to the lie. It depends if you're writing a happy story. Now, this third scene is usually at the climax. An example of a character succumbing to the lie is in 1984. This is when Winston Smith is being tortured, and in order to prevent his face from being eaten off by rats, he betrays his lover and succumbs to Big Brother. As if school wasn't depressing enough, they assign us the most depressing books. It's as if they want us to hate our lives. But to conclude, those are the main three scenes for a good character arc to really make it prominent so people notice it. Because personally, I am not the best at seeing character arcs, so it's good to have it fairly noticeable. Now, don't beat the reader over the head if you're trying to have some message, but definitely make it noticeable. Now, character development is good, but it's also important to avoid character derailment. Character derailment is when the character is so drastically changed that it throws readers off and usually doesn't even make sense from in the way that a character arc would. Now, this is most likely to happen within a series. However, it can also happen scene by scene. There are two ways to do character arcs in a series. Either have one overarching arc for the entire series or have a character arc for each individual book. And a good example of a series where a character has one character arc is the original Star Wars trilogy. Now, since this is a trilogy, it's an even better example because each scene that I listed before is in each consecutive movie. So for Luke Skywalker, in the first movie, A New Hope, we're introduced to him in his characteristic moment on Tatooine. In The Empire Strikes Back, Luke has his breaking point where the truth of who his father is revealed to him. And his childish beliefs that there is good and evil are broken, and he realizes that there's more nuance in the world than that. And then in the third movie, Return of the Jedi, Luke has his characteristic moment where he embraces the truth and saves the galaxy. Now, it's more common and also takes less plotting to do one character arc per book. However, I think it's important to note to not make each character arc too extreme as to alienate readers. And by extreme character arcs, I mean personality trait-based character arcs. So if you're doing a character arc per book, I recommend instead of doing personality-based flaws, instead have it be about overcoming some sort of internal lie. And a good example of a subtle internal character arc throughout a series is Percy Jackson. So, Percy is a bit socially awkward with a very quirky, funny personality. And being socially awkward is not necessarily a good thing. It's kind of a flaw. However, it's charming and is one of the reasons why readers like Percy. So, if in the first book he was quirky and socially awkward and he overcame that, by the second book, some readers would feel alienated and Percy would be less lovable because of it. So, instead of having him overcoming personality traits, Percy learns lessons and overcomes internal lies. Like in the first book, he learns that he has to do some things for the greater good over his personal desires. And then in the second book, instead of having Percy overcome some sort of personality trait, instead the main internal dilemma for Percy is that he has a half-brother that's kind of dorky and sometimes embarrasses him. And Percy needs to learn that it doesn't matter what other people think of him and his half-brother, and that he should be there for his half-brother. So within these two books, even though Percy grows and has a character arc within each book, his personality remains the same. Therefore, readers who loved his personality won't feel alienated. Now, you can have extreme personality changes of a character in a series. However, be careful, and I also highly recommend have these personality changes be on the page. Because some readers who love that character will feel alienated, and sometimes the changes won't make sense if we don't get to see them change. Now, you can have your character physically change off the page. We don't need to see every single training sequence, but keep personality changes on the page. And a good example of a character having drastic personality changes, but it's on the page in a series, is the Ranger's Apprentice. In the first book of the Ranger's Apprentice, Will's character arc is pretty basic. It's dorky orphan finding his place in the world and learning to accept that he isn't as strong as a knight, and that he has his own talents and skills that are just as important. Whereas in later books in this series, Will gets captured, enslaved, ends up getting addicted to a very addictive and deadly plant withers away to practically a zombie and then has to get weaned off the drug and gain his strength back and become who he once was. That is an extreme character change. However, all of it happens on the page. The reader never feels lost and wondering what happened to their character. And also, Will eventually does gain the personality traits that we've grown to love back. Though the trauma remains with him, his personality does return, so readers aren't completely alienated. But my main point is, if you're going to go extreme, do it on the page like this story does. The only example of a book where the character changes off the page and it makes sense would be in The Uglies, where Tally has brain surgery. However, if the reasoning is not as extreme as this, I definitely recommend showing us the character's personality change. My final point is, make sure what happens in the plot fits the character arc and do not have them contradict each other. Because if your character's lesson is then immediately contradicted by the plot and how the character must succeed for the external struggle, it will kind of throw readers off. So if the lesson your character learns is they can't always get everything they want, then don't give them everything they want. So that's all I have to say for character arcs for now. If you have anything you want to add, feel free to discuss it below, and I'll see you later.